your nice warm bed. You just remember what your old past said, or you got a friend in me.
Good morning, Gallup Hill School.
Would everyone please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Would everyone please remain standing for a moment of silence?
Good morning, Colonel. Would everyone please raise their right hand and repeat the Bark Pledge with us? I promise to be accepting, responsible, and kind. Everyone may now be seated.
It's now time for a morning announcement.
A mess. What are you looking for? A biography on Harriet Tubman? Who was Harriet Tubman? Well, her name was Araminta Ross when she was born in Maryland around 1820. She changed her name to Harriet Tubman later on. She was born a slave and had to work even when she was very young. And when she was a little older, she was forced to work in the fields. Harriet Tubman always stood up for herself and others. Once she protected a slave from an angry overseer, and he threw a metal weight that hit her in the head. For the rest of her life, Harriet Tubman would faint and fall into a deep sleep. But that didn't stop her from doing some incredible things. First, she ran away to Philadelphia, a city in the north. Then she returned to the south to help many of her family members escape. She brought them to Canada, where she knew they would be safe. But Harriet Tubman didn't do it all alone. What was the Underground Railroad? Well, the Underground Railroad wasn't really a railroad. Slaves escaped north on secret routes, with the help of a group of abolitionists. Abolitionists are people working to end slavery. Harriet Tubman was a conductor on the Underground Railroad and led passengers to different stations. The stations were safe houses. Safe houses were homes and businesses that took in escaped slaves. Many safe houses had lanterns in front or candles in the windows at night, as signals that they were safe. Station masters were people who took in and hid slaves. They risked their lives in order to fight slavery. Harriet Tubman made about 19 trips to the South and helped over 300 slaves escape. There was a reward for her capture, but she never got caught. Good question, Moby. How did slavery end? When the Civil War broke out, Harriet helped the North. Harriet Tubman worked as a cook, nurse, and even a spy during the war. President Abraham Lincoln made the Emancipation Proclamation, which promised freedom to the slaves in the South. Then Congress passed the 13th Amendment, which made slavery illegal everywhere in the United States. Even though slavery was abolished, African Americans still faced a lot of problems. They were treated poorly, just because of the color of their skin. But for the rest of her life, Harriet Tubman stood up for equal rights for African Americans and women. Harriet Tubman sure inspires me to be brave. But Moby, you're never gonna find that book on Harriet Tubman. Because I have it right here. It's my favorite book. Hey!
That's all for our program today. Thanks for listening.
Thanks, everyone. Have a great day. Bye!